Hello viewers, very rarely as a book reviewer I am faced with a situation where I find that I am too insignificant a person compared to the product that I am going to review, especially because of the content it carries, the relevance of that content, the effectiveness of that content, the purposefulness of that content. So compared to all this, I find myself too insignificant a person to speak about it. I am faced with a similar situation when I review this book, Rural Marketing by Mr. Pradeep Kashyap. Now, to me, Mr. Kashyap truly is the father of rural marketing in India. His activity that involved the success of Project Shakti in this country, his overall optimism towards rural markets, his progressive mentality towards rural markets, the way he has guided a number of corporate houses to look towards rural India, to customize products towards rural India. So he has truly been one crusader who has talked about a better India, a better rural India, and he has been one person who has been vocal about looking rural, because that's where the fortune as far as the marketers lie. Now, in this particular review, I am going to speak about the second edition of Rural Marketing book. However, the third edition is presently in the market. Since I have extensively gone through this edition, I will be restricting my review to this edition, and I am sure that the third edition of this book has been even better. Now, when I say that I am too minuscule a person to review this particular book, I rightly say so, because the cover of this book talks about the late C.K. Prahlad, one of the doyens of management, management practice, management consulting, and one of the most revered authors of the book, The Fortune at the Bottom of the Pyramid, who says that Pradeep Kashyap is known as the father of rural India. So after such a person commenting on Mr. Kashyap, I don't think that one requires any other passport, so to say, to prove the amount of wealth that this particular book contains. Further, this book has a foreword by Jagdish Sheth, and again he happens to be one of the doyens when it comes to management, literature, practice and consulting. Now, this particular book, Rural Marketing, there have been several features that have been extremely interesting for me, starting with the chapter 1 that talks of the call of rural India. And here Mr. Kashyap talks about the progressive aspects of rural India. He talks about a rural marketing mix, and he talks about the potential and the promise that rural marketing holds for marketers. He then goes back to the evolution of rural marketing in this country, and subsequently he talks of the segmentation, market targeting, market positioning strategies, and rural market research. That is definitely one chapter that I have thoroughly I have been enriched in my knowledge, because we are all aware of various market research practices, tools and techniques when it comes to urban markets. But when it comes to rural markets, and where people are oblivious to a lot of things, a large chunk of the population is illiterate or semi-literate, so to engage such a population in any market research activity, there requires various improvisation and customization of certain tools and techniques which have been mentioned in this particular chapter. Also, the participatory rural appraisal or PRA tools have been discussed in detail and with adequate exhibits, which makes this particular chapter one of the best chapters in this book. Further continuing with the contents of the book, Mr. Kashyap has gone in extensive detail talking about the four A's of rural marketing, comparing with the four P's of rural marketing that we are aware of, where we talk of product, price, place and promotion. There are certain aspects which are its equivalent when it comes to rural markets, and that has what been discussed in this book. There have been few additional chapters in this particular edition of the book, along with an additional CD which comes with lot of resources which are associated with the book. Now, one of the chapters which talks about emergence of small town India is a very, very fascinating read, and especially how Mr. Kashyap has gone in detail to prove that the rise of Mahendra Singh Dhoni, one of the former Indian captains, and how his rise is connected with the rise of small town India, because he has been one personality who has grown from the backyards of this country, and he has grown into a huge, huge international phenomenon, and it has been the brands that have associated with Mahendra Singh Dhoni that have also been enlightened to the idea of considering small town India when it compares to it is about marketing. So over here, Mr. Kashyap, through this Dhoni effect, he says that there was a point of time when the marketers used to neglect small town India, but with the phenomenal rise of Mahendra Singh Dhoni in cricket, they have definitely understood that they cannot leave out small town India, because if they are not including them in their marketing plans, they are going to be doomed any day. So how they have been able to customize their marketing efforts, and how they have been able to woo the audience associated with these markets, that has what been discussed in this particular chapter. Overall, Rural Marketing by Mr. Pradeep Kashyap, I will say, is not just a great and one of the best textbooks on rural marketing that is available in Indian markets, but I will say that it's a great reference book. It's a great tool for all rural marketing practitioners, because the amount of richness that this book contains, the amount of practical practicalities and the practical things that are associated with the book, in terms of the case studies, in terms of the marketing insights, in terms of the exhibits, in terms of the various content that have been discussed in each chapter, this happens to be one extremely, extremely phenomenal book when it comes to understanding rural marketing in the context of India. So for me, it's one of the most recommended reads if you are really someone who is enthusiastic about understanding rural India and how to market effectively in rural India.